So Oxygen OS 11 is finally official. So you now can download Oxygen OS 11 for OnePlus 8 and 8 Pro. The installation is really simple. Download this file, place it in your internal storage and do a local upgrade from settings. Do note, upgrading won't wipe your data but downgrading back will. So make sure to keep a backup if you want to test it. So there are many visual changes, and with the Oxygen OS 11 it's clear OnePlus is moving away from stock Android. The user interface is similar to One UI, and that's cause OnePlus is also following the same approach as Samsung to make the interface easy for one-handed users. These are some of the preloaded applications. Owned by Facebook apps you can uninstall, and Netflix is something you cannot, so please welcome bloatwares. Now the animations are really smooth and we'll start with the lock screen. Oxygen OS 11 versus Oxygen OS 10, Android 11 versus 10, and you won't find a huge difference in the lock screen. Home screen is the place where all differences begins. So we have some brand new big and bold icons. The notification panel is also different. This latest OS divides notification to conversation, notifications and other notifications. You also get an option to see notification history in case you missed any or swiped any. The quick setting panel got a major redesign, and this design shows how user interface got affected because of the hole punch design. The quick settings is now long and icons are bigger. You also got dark mode, which works really well. It's no longer a theme, which we saw in Oxygen OS 10, and this is a full integrated dark mode. Here are some applications I wanna show you guys. This one is a dark mode versus OnePlus 7 Pro theme. So not a huge gap, but you will surely see some small changes in there. Now I'll show you system applications one by one, and difference is huge. So dialer, you can see we have the one-handed integration there also. The top text is large and they are simply making use of space. The call screen also got major redesign. Here's the SOS screen and here's the normal dialer screen. Messages, again some really huge changes like icon color and text on top and also normal text. The contact and label menu is gone, which is more clean and great. The new message now shows attachment size on top and it's more clean. Here's the camera application, and now you have new permissions. Allow while using the application only, which is really secure. There's nothing new in the camera application interface. We now have a new share menu which you can use after long pressing recent taken image like this. Okay, so camera takes us to the gallery. This is the new gallery. Again, major redesign changes, and I like the new one cause it has clean interface and the sections are now more near swipe. You also get an option for hiding images, which works really well. And so you can see you have to learn these changes. It's not something you'll get used to easily. Recorder, new interface and new sections. Calculator, again major design change, and 1 plus equals 2, never settle. The icons are bigger and the interface also feels large. So now moving to the settings cause it is important. This looks familiar, right? This design is inspired by One UI. The customization section is now normalish, it's now list. The icons and infographics are just text and sections. Exciting part is Oxygen OS 11 finally comes with always on display. You can enable it from ambient display settings. Yes, you got it right. Oxygen OS 10 has ambient display, which is like double tap to wake. And this one is what OnePlus calls always on ambient display. It has got new always on called Insight, which shows you the usage. This includes unlocks, how much you used your phone. And there's also one coming which is called Human Shadow. It will draw a sketch on your always on display using AI. And it is cool. This will remind you of your family and friends, which is like good thing. The about phone section also got some changes. It's no longer a two row spec sheet. They have now made it a list-like interface, as I said earlier. ZenMode also got new features like 90 minutes and 120 minutes plus 3 different modes, and it looks cool. Exciting part is you can now join with your family and friends and put your phone down together. That is something really cool. This is the weather application. It's now real life looking, and there are some new animation and the new infographics which I really like. By the way, you can install some of these applications on Oxygen OS 10 and it's gonna work great there also. Finally, Recents got no new changes. It's same as before, which is fine, cause there was no need for one. So this all, guys, this sums up all a major and much needed interface from OnePlus. They'll start the global stable rollout in mid-October, and it's coming soon to OnePlus 7 series, 70 series, 6 series and 60 series, and the OnePlus Nord also in a few months. So like, subscribe, and I'll meet you guys in the next one. Peace out.